Trick or treat opens the door for satanic activity. It's a nice Sunday and Saturday afternoon and everybody's out. Gonna have a good time, we're gonna party. I'm just looking at the human family right now. Everybody's gonna party. And they're gonna worship Satan and they don't even realize who they're worshiping. Do you know there's only two spirits? Hey, how you doing, young man? You good? You gonna get drunk tonight, are you? Or you wanna get saved? People up there playing their music, getting drunk, getting high, smoking, cussing, and probably later on start swearing, fighting. That's what it happens when you serve Satan. And you are serving Satan, let's be real. There's only two spirits in this world. There's the spirit of the Antichrist, you need to repent. You know Jesus as your Savior? There's two spirits in this world. One is of the Antichrist, one is of the Spirit of God. And we're here to spread the gospel that Jesus Christ died on the cross and you still have a chance. It's giving you an opportunity to make heaven. Or do you rather continue to party in your sin? Do you know what you're doing? I used to party at you guys once, drink and smoke and have a woman. And what does it profit you at the end of the day? You might go out, you might have a few drinks, you might get laid. Getting laid and having a few drinks. Do you know Jesus Christ, my young man? Do you know Christ? You say, you know that Jesus died for you, yeah? You gonna serve him then?
Every day.
Is that your husband? It's your husband. That's good. Is that your wife? Excellent. But this is what I'm trying to say. People say I'm too bold. I'm not too bold. I'm just being upfront. We're on. Where are we? Malcolm X, the famous Malcolm X, and Main Street. And we sent here to preach the good news, we sent here to preach the gospel. And to let you guys know that Jesus died for you. Do you know that Jesus died for you? Have you repented of your sins though? That's the thing. Jesus died for you, but have you repented of your sins? There's a difference between saying, yes, I know Jesus, and having a relationship. Big difference. Hallelujah. Amen. Somebody said amen. I don't know who that was. It was you. So you agree with what I said? Then when you say amen, that means you agree with what I said. Hallelujah. I'm not too forward here. You know? We are preaching repentance. If you guys don't make hope tonight, are you guaranteed to make heaven? That's the thing. How do you know? Are you born again? Are you washed in the blood of Jesus? Do you serve Jesus or just know of him? There's a difference between knowing God and having a relationship with God. So you know one day you're going to stand before him and you're going to give an account of your life. He's going to hold you accountable of your life. Do you know that? This partying and drinking and womanizing and drugs only can last for a split second. It's only a temporal fix. Your mate's laughing at me. Come on, let me say something. Don't be scared, man. What's his name? Introduce yourself to social media.
Hey. We're in doubt. They want people to repent. They want to follow the truth. It's so easy to do all the other things. It's so easy to rely on alcohol, to rely on sex. It's so easy to rely on food instead of walking that deep walk that the Spirit of God has for his people.
Okay, man.
Give me some Bible
questions.
man.
Jesus is coming. Get your house in order.
That's what we want to hear. We got our sisters backing us up. You see? You can never say you didn't hear the gospel now. We got our sisters across the road, man. And we got us here. So God is warning you. God is warning you that he's coming. That Jesus Christ appearance is coming soon, young man, young lady. Everybody shaking their heads and they don't want Jesus, but when Jesus comes, you're going to have to give an account. Do you know that? You need to repent. Just as John the Baptist said when Jesus was coming, we are proclaiming that you need to repent. There is a day coming when you will be judged. Your drink, your cigarettes, your drugs, your smoke, your weed, or whatever, is not going to help you. If you're not washed in the blood of Jesus, you will go to hell. I used to be a gangster back in England, because that's where I'm from. As they would say, I used to be a bad man on the streets. I thought I was a bad man. But I wasn't a bad man. I just give God thanks that I'm still here. Because I should have been dead. This is why you need repentance. Because what does it profit you to gain sex, drugs, money, alcohol, everything, but to lose your one soul? You've got one soul. Only one soul you have. And that soul is going to go back to the Creator, the God who created you in his own image. And Jesus is going to ask you a question. He's going to say, when those two preachers were preaching, or when you heard the gospel, you denied me. Do you want to hear him say that? I certainly don't. This is why we preach repentance. We preach repentance because Jesus Christ is coming. Hallelujah. Team Adam, you need to turn away from your sin. You may ask me, what is sin? As I keep saying, sin is everything against God. That's what sin is. God paid the price with his life for you. And even now, he breathes breath, he allows you to breathe. Hallelujah. This is why we preach the good news of Jesus. Do you love God, man? Do you love Jesus, sir? You don't love him? Do you know that when you say you don't love him, he will hold you accountable for that? In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. People are so scared. The gospel is such an offense. You know why the gospel is an offense? Because it highlights the darkness you are living in. The gospel highlights the darkness you are living in the name of Jesus. We come out every week all over Dallas to let you guys know that you need a Savior, and his name is Jesus Christ. You've all heard of him because he died for you. He made the absolute sacrifice by giving himself so you can live. But there's a price. Hallelujah. Do you love Jesus? You do. You sure you love Jesus? Hallelujah. So you need to turn